very special for Denny Hamlin. He won the Xfinity Series race yesterday, and now he completes the sweep. Denny Hamlin in victory lane once again, now in the Monster Energy Cup Series. Kristen.
It's familiar territory for Denny Hamlin. He was here yesterday, as you said, Rick, the weekend sweep, the second time in his career, both times at Darlington. He got to talk to the fans, and he steps back and looks at this. So cool. The flying modified is back. The number 11, the winningest number in all of NASCAR, and you do it again. I know you've been here before, but it's been 7 years since you won the Southern 500. What does it mean to do it on Throwback Weekend and on Labor Day Weekend?
You know, it means everything to me. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, this is a throwback to my history. This is for Roy Hendrick, Bucks Hairfield, Wayne Patterson, all Eddie Johnson, the short track guys that I grew up watching. This was a throwback to them. Back in 1985 to 1989, I was at Southside Speedway in the stands, watching them race and learning everything I could from them. And this is a throwback to them and their history. And Rick Hendrick, I can't thank him enough because he got the modified back together. He was very excited. Rick Hendrick actually got his first job on the Flying 11, so hats off to him. My whole Sport Clips team, Toyota, FedEx, Interstate Batteries, Coca-Cola, the Jordan brand, NASCAR, and all the fans. There's another donation to Safe Driving Kids, leading on these laps, so this is a good day all in all. So proud to be back from victory lane here at the Southern 500.
It's a win for South Carolina, but you mentioned all of those guys from Virginia, win for them as well. And I know somebody's really happy that Daddy's back in victory lane. Taylor was the one high-fiving everybody as they came in. You gave everybody high-fives, didn't you, sweetie?
Uh-huh.
Who won?
Daddy won two times, that's right. And when you won the Southern 500 back in 2010, you weren't a daddy. Now you've got Taylor, you've got little Miss Molly at home, Jordan's here. I know this is special for your entire family.
So special. And to have the family around, the friends around, it means so much more. And to have a two-week-old at home, I can't wait to get back to her. But Taylor gets so excited anytime Daddy wins. And we'd like to make this a more reoccurring thing.
Thanks, Denny. And it's not complete unless I get a high five from Taylor. There we go, sweetie.
And we continue to talk about momentum. Denny Hamlin now with momentum. He's going to go to Richmond, a racetrack that is virtually his home track. Grew up just miles away from Richmond. But an eventful night for Denny Hamlin. Again, coming to pit road for what would have been the final time. And he missed pit road. Slick tires coming in too hot. And so many times we've seen it where a driver just misjudges. Then after the fresh tires are on there, he's battling, fighting to try to get back up to the 78. We take a look at tonight's Coca-Cola winning moment for Denny Hamlin, the 78 of Martin Truex Jr. up into the wall. He scrubs the wall just ever so slightly, but then the tire goes down. Denny Hamlin takes advantage of it, and that propels him to his second Southern 500 win. And he mentioned this one, so much sweeter. And Taylor saying, it's so much better when Daddy wins. Twice this weekend.
So cool to hear him talk about not only Ray Hendrick, but all the people that meant something to him back in Virginia that he raced against or even watched racing as a young child, watching him race Southside Speedway. And great for Sport Clips and everybody for allowing him to honor those people. I mean, it takes the sponsors to be willing to do it as well. But you can truly see and hear the emotion from Denny Hamlin about what those racers meant to him.
And whenever there's someone who is excited about the ending of a race, that means that there's got to be somebody who's disappointed. And it would have to be Martin Truex Jr. Let's go to Dave.
Well, it doesn't look like there's much more that he could have done tonight after winning the first couple of stages. Describe the ending, Martin.
It's a tough one, man, you know, sometimes those things just don't go your way, and tonight, not much did. We had the fast car, took the lead four or five different times, and just had a phenomenal race car and long runs, and at the end, it was just two laps too long, just blew it right front, so didn't see that coming, didn't really have any issues all night on the right fronts, but circumstances there were a little bit different with a green flag stopping, running pretty long. We had them till that, but that's the way it goes. Proud of everybody, and proud of the regular season championship deal. That's huge for this team, huge for me, my career, and a lot of points for the championship bonus. So just go try to get more points next week and go to the playoffs.
Tell us what it was like trying to manhandle the car there at the end with no tires before the tire went and a very loose race car.
That's all I had, I can tell you that. I mean, I'm pretty whooped, but I think we could have held him off if the tire didn't pop. if I had a little bit of clean air, I was okay. You know, I could hold my own, and I get in lap traffic, and I just about wrecked, just spinning out loose. It's a tough place, but it's so much fun. I love it, and wish we could have got this one tonight, but that's the way it goes. Thanks to Johnny Morris, Tracker Boats, for this throwback scheme, and it's just a fun weekend, and thinking about everybody in Texas. Hopefully they'll get back to normal soon.
Strong night. Huge challenge nearly met at the end.
And Martin mentioned how big this is for his career. He just won the regular season. And how big is that? Well, he's getting 15 more bonus points, more playoff points, which right now this doesn't reflect that. He only has 37 with one race to go. But he will get those 15 more playoff points at the end of the Richmond race. And he could potentially either win the Richmond race or win a stage or two to add to those numbers. But that'll put him to 52 points compared to the guys he's competing against now. And you take a look at if they reset the points. Again, we have one race to go before they'll do it. But resetting the points, 2,052 points to second place.